That's my 3D printer, and that is my 3D printer with a conveyor belt. By adding a conveyor belt, my 3D printer can now print infinitely long print jobs. Literally, infinitely long. This mod has completely changed what I can make on my 3D printer, and it's surprisingly easy to do. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can add a conveyor belt to your 3D printer. You don't need any expensive equipment, you don't need any fancy machines. All you need is 8 minutes. I'll be doing this mod on a brand new Artillery Hornet 3D printer. Now you can add a conveyor belt to pretty much any FDM 3D printer. But I've designed all of the CAD to specifically match the Artillery Hornet. So if you want to copy this tutorial exactly, I'd recommend grabbing one of these 3D printers. You can do so for a discounted price at the link in the description. Now that your 3D printer is assembled and working, let's take it apart. We'll start off by removing the Y axis. Make sure to keep the stepper motor handy, as we'll be using it later on to drive the conveyor belt. At this link, you can access the CAD for the project. More specifically, you can access STL files for all of the parts you have to print out. I made sure that every single part you need in this project can be 3D printed. You don't need to buy anything on Amazon, you don't need to machine anything, all you need is 3D printing. After printing everything out, we can start assembling these pieces. This can be a lot of work, so I recommend getting an extra set of hands. I realize nobody wants to see a long, drawn-out assembly video, so I'll try to montage through this as quickly as I can. A lot of people ask this question, and the answer depends. I have a lot to say about all of the different conveyor belts that I tested on my 3D printer. In fact, I made a separate video that documents all of your conveyor belt options. You should definitely check it out if you're trying to determine which conveyor belt is best. But the short answer? I ended up finding a guy that sold conveyor belts specifically made for 3D printers. Unsurprisingly, these conveyor belts had the exact combination of material properties that we need. By far, I got my best quality prints using these conveyor belts that were specifically made for conveyor belt 3D printers. They are a bit pricey at $40 per unit, but you can get them for a 20% discount using my promo code. To my knowledge, I am the only person anywhere on the internet offering this discount, so my link is literally the cheapest possible way to get this conveyor belt. And now, with this frickin' thing assembled, let's try running a test print. But before we do, we should probably explain how a conveyor belt 3D printer works, because we're a bunch of nerds! A traditional FDM 3D printer works by depositing material layer by layer on the print bed, thereby additively producing a part.
Eventually, the extruder cannot move any higher in the Z-axis, and the max build height of the 3D printer is reached. On the other hand, a conveyor belt 3D printer deposits material at a 45-degree angle to the print bed. After each layer, the conveyor belt moves slightly forwards. Because the conveyor belt can move infinitely forwards in this axis, a conveyor belt 3D printer can produce infinitely long parts. Due to the way that a conveyor belt 3D printer prints, the manufactured parts have some pretty nifty structural properties. A traditional print job will be strongest when I apply a tensile load that's in line with the print layers, and weakest when I apply a tensile load that's perpendicular to the print layers. But a conveyor belt print job is equally strong in both directions. Also, due to the print grain, a conveyor belt print job will have a much higher max shear stress than a traditional print job. Obviously, we can't make all of these changes to the 3D printer without letting the 3D printer know. We need to flash updated firmware on the machine so it can operate as a conveyor belt 3D printer. The changes that I made to the firmware are super simple. All I did was get rid of the endstock for the conveyor belt axis and put in a very large value for the max conveyor belt position so that it never hits a limit. In order to make the G-code for the print jobs, you need to use a custom slicer. There are a couple of different options you can use, but the best one in my opinion is Black Belt Cura. It's open source and free to use. You can find a link to it in the description. Finally, it's printing time. You may have noticed that a couple of components on the 3D printer changed color during the video.
The location that I'm filming in has also changed.
Yeah.
In the middle of making this video, I moved from Toronto, Canada to Kigali, Rwanda. I'm here to install the exact same 3D printer you just saw me build at a local makerspace. Rwandan entrepreneurs, students, youth will get to use the 3D printer for their technical projects. And I think that's frickin' awesome. What's less frickin' awesome is that a lot of components on the 3D printer actually broke during the 14-hour flight, so I had to reprint them after I landed in the city. My apologies for the continuity errors. If you want more details about this project, check out the thorough documentation that I've linked in the YouTube description. And if you have any questions at all, please leave a comment and I'll get to it as soon as possible. And if you want to see more videos like this, well, you know what to do.